Hey guys, this is the second video for our Advanced Jazz and Contemporary class. Today we're going to go through our warm-up like normal, and then we'll go ahead and go into reviewing for our jazz dance. You guys all have a video, I'm pretty sure, of you guys doing the dance. So I'm just going to do a review of it, and then you guys can use that full video that you have to practice that. So we'll do our warm-up, we'll go through the jazz. Last week's video we went through the contemporary, so you should have a pretty good understanding of both of those dances. And then after that we'll do some across the floor, maybe work on some turns, and then finish with a cool down just like we did last time. If you have any questions on anything, I told you guys this last week, feel free to text me, send me a message. If you have any questions on the dance or on certain steps or any problems that you're having with that. So go ahead and spread out, find just some space that you can warm up, and we'll go ahead and get ready. Breathe out, lower your arms,
Plie, breathe in, lower your arms on that. Six, back, and five, six, ready, and breathe in, and out. Feet together wherever you want them. Roll shoulders. to turn back and roll front. Shrug one at a time. Up.
Thank you.
the left. And flip it up. Grab your fingers. Thank you. knees to the floor and stretch back. Good butterfly position.
Next thing we're going to do is just, you can kind of do your choice on this today. So take a minute, kind of like we do in class sometimes. If you want to do a little bit of running, get your heart going, maybe some jumping jacks. If you feel like doing some push-ups, or maybe some crunches, you could do a wall sit. Whatever you want to do, we're going to do that for about 3 minutes. I'm going to play some music. You can kind of use that to do whatever you want to do. You can kind of switch it back and forth. This is just kind of like what we do in class, usually when I give you guys kind of that free time to do whatever you need. Or if you just need to stretch out some more, we did a long stretch today, so you should be pretty stretched out. But if there's something else you need to do, go ahead and take that time now. I'm going to play some music for just about 3 minutes. And then we're going to get moving into your dance.
Thank you.
1 minute left. Keep it up.
To go over, get down. So we use a chair for that, right? So if you need a chair, or if you have, rather, not if you need a chair, if you have a chair that you can dance on, go ahead and grab that and make sure it's a kind of chair that if you stand on it, it's not gonna break, and that you're allowed to stand on it. If not, just pretend with that. You can definitely do the beginning part, even if it was just like, I don't know, whatever kind of chair you could do at the beginning, but the parts where we stand up on it and stuff, just make sure it's not gonna break so that we don't have any broken arms when we get back to class. Last week, I think when we were doing it, or rather when I was doing it with the music, it got a little too confusing with the right and left, because when I'm doing it on the computer, my right is your left, and so I think that got a little confusing. So like I said a minute ago, I'm going to just go through it. Just kind of looking at some of the details, making sure that you guys know the ending part as well. I don't know, honestly don't even remember at this point if people were missing the last week. So just going through it, making sure that we know what we're doing. This one is not finished, but we were close. So once we get back to class, it's not going to be any trouble at all to go ahead and get this finished, as long as you guys are practicing. So we'll just go through everything today. If you don't have a video of the whole thing, send a message to, if you're in the group text message, I think most of you have a cell phone. I think Keegan, you might be the only one, but you can have your mom send me a Facebook message or a text message if you need the video. But you guys can text each other, because I know most of you guys videoed it that last week of class. I don't necessarily have the video. If one of you wants to send it to me, that'd be awesome. But use that for your practicing. And if you want a copy of the music, send me a text, either music, the burn or the get down, and I can email that out to you if you want that to practice with rather than the video. Like if you know it and you don't need to look at it and you just want the music, we can do that. So go ahead and get a chair or whatever you're gonna use, or if you're not using a chair, whatever you're doing, go ahead and grab that.
So. So we start out and we are facing the back. I think you guys know this part pretty well. So it starts and you look up, and then you have your shoulder, and then you have snap, and then you guys go over your chair and you end up facing the front, and this is where I'm gonna have to just stand up because it's gonna get backwards. So you go over your chair and you get to face the front. So you took your leg over, and I think we decided the last week that we would try and do that with a straight leg and pointed toes. So you're here, hand is out when you get here. So your leg went up and around, you're here, and then you look away and you have the two rolling snaps. One, two. Then you keep looking at the wall. This is some of those details that we've kind of lost when we've just been doing it, because you guys know the steps, but you keep looking at the wall. So you roll one, two, look at the wall, you windmill, and you cross this leg over, and then your head is that next thing. Boom. And then from there, I believe it's this shoulder, and up on that. So all of that is really sharp on the snaps. So you're facing the back, it goes You hold the first boom, snap. You have shoulder and snap around. So your leg comes up and around. Snap. Look away. Snap. Snap. Keep looking at the wall. Cross it over. Head on the snap. Snap. And then shoulder and snap on that as well. So that part I think you know pretty well. Just think about where your head is. And think about pointing your toes. Even though it's simple stuff, it's snapping and things like that, think about what the rest of your body looks like and make sure you look like you're dancing, right? So from there, we have this little slide to the floor. I know I told you guys, if you don't have your middle split, fake it till you make it, you can kind of cheat it. But we're also kind of getting into this thing where it looks like we're just like plopping on the floor. So hold your weight on your chair a little bit. Even if you're not going out into a full split, make sure it's not just like plopping, you know what I mean? So you're going out and you get down to the floor. And we wanna try to keep our legs out in that nice straddle before we go to the side. Let's see, I'm backwards. So we roll this way. It's a mermaid roll, I believe. So feet come up and we're here and we spin to face your chair. I think I spun the wrong way. You spin to the back. Yeah. It's really, this is what I'm talking about. It's confusing because I'm backwards from you. Anyways. And then we have, you reach up and make sure your feet look nice on this. So you've got one crossed over and one is tucked. So it's up, back. Once you go back, then this foot can come out because you're getting ready to hinge up. But when you spin around, you're in this position. This toe is pointed, this leg is up, up, back, and then you hinge up. I'm not going to hinge today. I actually have a compression fracture in one of my vertebrae, so we're not gonna do that. But you hinge up on there. And then from there, you step up on your chair. That part gets a little bit speedy. You guys can tend to rush through it. So I know I said we weren't gonna do it with music, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play the music from the beginning and I'm just gonna talk through it like I would in class where we have the boom, snap, around, that kind of thing. If you wanna just mark through that beginning part. Let's see. All right, so we're sitting in our chair. Boom, snap, around. Roll, roll, around, up, down, spin around,
in the past that I
up,
to bring me
and pinch,
keep it on the bone, fill my goblet up to the brim.
So that's on, you spin around, you spin around, and then bring me some pheasant, and you hinge up, keep it on the bone. And then there's the part where she doesn't say anything. That's when you stand up on your chair. Make sure you're standing up on your chair, not just like, oh, I'm getting up on this chair now. But make sure it's kind of like in character. So you're the queen, this is your throne, and you can stand on it. So you're just up. Bring me some, then it's, bring me some, doesn't keep it on the bone, bum. Then you're here, fill mine. So this is a nice tight passe. Parallel, my foot is touching, and I have this strong hand push. This is fill mine. You look at the audience, so you're looking at your hand right now. Fill mine. And then you look at the audience on goblet. Your leg comes down, and it's kind of this like sassy, like throw it, bring your knees around. So my knees just kind of swivel. So I go from this bevel to this bevel. And my hands are just kind of casual on that. So it was here. I stepped up on the quiet part. Fill my goblet up to the brim. Then you jump down. And this one is not like a big jump. It's just a little like jump off. And these are the actual chairs we'll be using too. So sipping on meat and I spill it on my dress. So legs are nice and turned out, good wide second position. Then we cross, out, slide. And my, sorry, I'm on the wrong foot for you. There. And my head stays up on that part. The next part where we have this is where the tilt happens. So you jumped up, fill my goblet up to the brim, sipping on mead, and I spill it on my dress with the gold lace trim. So it's just, you're like looking at the dress, you've got trim down there. Gold lace trim, not very, I'm gonna tilt it the wrong way, hold on. Prim and proper. So we're here. Prim and proper. And when I pull that up to proper, I'm like up on the tips of my toes. And then we go, right shoulder. Can't make me stop. So we were here, we were nice and proper. Can't make me stop. So we've talked about this is, she's kind of not your typical like girly girl queen kind of thing going on. She's very, I don't know what the word, I look boisterous maybe? I don't know, if you can think of a better word. But she's saying that she's not prim and proper, so she's kind of making fun of that. So you're here, I want to see a big difference between this and here. It's like we're in our dress sitting on our throne really fancy, and then we're about to like watch some football or something, I don't know. So here, can't make me stop. Then you stand up, push, pull, head. Can't make me stop. I wanna go. Is that what that is? Or I think that's all. I wanna go hunting every day. I know the head whips on every day. So it's push and head around on that. So I'm going to talk you through that section now.
To bring me some pheasant, keep it on the bone.
And step up,
fill my goblet up to the
brim, down,
on mead, and I set it on my
dress with the gold lace trim,
not very
prim and proper. Can't make me stop.
I wanna go
hunting every day.
Get back for a ride.
Hunting.
I'm a player, 'cause I'm a player.
So you see it up, I was confused with that. You see it up on I wanna go. This is hunting every day. Then we go head back, four up. So my legs kind of go, they're on this like four-starch releve, and it's turn out, turn in, turn out, turn in. This hand's just kind of chilling. Make sure it's not doing anything weird, but it's just there. That part I know we've had some struggling with. So hunting every day, head back, four up. If it's really throwing you off, do it slow. And just turn out and turn out and then try and take it up to the releve, out and out. And the reason you're on releve is because it's easier to kind of pivot your foot if it's already up. And then you have this little jumpy turn where your foot comes up in a passe. So I'm going to do it this way. You pick up your right foot. So right foot comes up in a passe, right hand goes up. So you go up, and then it slides to the floor on that. So we went hunting every day, head back for a round, and then you go down to the floor of croquet. Whoop, I'm off the screen. Let me scoot back. And then this hand is up under your head. This hand is just here. I think it's bent up. And then we're here. Do we grab that? No, your hand just stays. Croquet, yeah, because I'm a player. And on tomorrow you sit up and you're looking at the audience, I'll hit replay. That snap, replay. And you look at it on play. Hit replay. But we took out these shoulders because we decided we didn't have enough time for all that. So, you're going to windmill,
to stand up to the back.
And then you would walk this way. And you're pointing with your right hand. That's another part where it's going to get confusing because I'm facing the wrong way. So we did fill my goblet up to the brim, sipping on me, spit on my dress with the gold lace trim. Not very prim and proper. Can't make me stop. I want to go hunting every day. Head back for a posse up, run a croquet up, because I'm a player. Sit up tomorrow, I'll hit replay. No shoulders. You said that I tricked. Yeah. So you're walking. It's not walking anywhere. It's just kind of in place. Got an attitude. Pointing at them on that. Let's just mark that with music as well.
And tomorrow, I'll hit the gold lace trim goblet up to the brim. Sipping on
me, has put on my dress with the gold lace trim.
Not very
prim and proper.
Can't make me stop. I wanna go
hunting every day.
Head back for a
leg. Sit up.
And tomorrow,
I'll hit replay. Roll.
You said that.
Walk. Toes stuck on that. So, all right, you said that I tricked. Yeah, and then you step out right, left. Hold on. So you went right, left, and then you go, you have pat, two, three, four. So, hold on, I'm going to face away from you for a second. Right, left. It's the right. So you go right, left, one, two, three, four. And it's kind of just leaning into it. So, right, left, one, two, three, four. Then I'm just actually gonna turn away from you this part because it's confusing with the right and left. So, right, left, pat, two, three, four. Scoop, step. So it went right, left, one, two, three, four, and down. And down. So we walked. We stood up, we turned around. You walked forward with your right hand. Trick, yeah, because I didn't look like mine. And then your hands go pro, file, pick, jerk. So I'm going to go to that again. So you walked one, two, right, left. One, two, three, four. Scoop. Hands out, face tilt. And then after that, I'm just going to keep facing away from you guys for now. Sure. You have a pas de bourrée, so you step with your left foot. Left. Right. Step front. So you're in a preparation for a pirouette. It's just a single. And you land front with both feet apart, and you sink into that right hip twice. So all that, we went walk, one, two, out, one, two, three, four, scoop, head out, face tilt, pas de bourrée, pirouette, down, bounce. And that's just kind of like a casual, like, you were pulled up really tall. It's another moment where it's like, really proper, and then it's like, hey, kind of thing. So we're up and bounce, bounce. And from there, pirouette, down. You push off of this foot, and it's a little like, snap. It's gonna look like I'm going the wrong way for you, but you push up with your right foot, or you stand up onto your right foot, you kick the left out, and it's the right hand. So it's a turn like that. So if I were facing the front, see, I just went bounce, be there, going this way now. So
let's just do that part with music.
This is all stuff you've known, but right now we're just kind of looking at the details.
I'll get reflected from a player, cause I'm a player. And tomorrow I'll get
reflected. Now you roll to stand up.
You said that
I tricked you. Out, out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Scoop, scoop. Paddle, right? And turn.
Surprise leap.
So we were here, we went bounce, bounce, you went snap, you're going this way. You're gonna we're going this way, sorry. You're gonna chasse on your right foot, step on your left. That takes you kind of forward. So we went chasse, step, leap. It's a surprise leap. Ooh, I went off the screen. It's a surprise leap. So you look like you're starting to go this way. And then just kidding, I leap forward. So, chasse, step, leap. You squat to the floor. Sorry, all the way squat down. You pop up. You roll up. You snap out. And then we all go around. That's can't. Then you all have your own thing. Stop me. So, and we talked about them. If you don't remember what it was, make something up. It's two poses. So we all go can't. A lot of times we end up skipping that. Can't, and you pose stop, me, and then we all come here. Oops, sorry, wrong way. On cuts. So it goes, we stood up. I was on the wrong can't too. I'm so sorry, guys. And you can't stop me, cuts. And then from there we roll. I'm the queen. It's kind of like a little like, I don't know, think about like somebody who's making an evil plot. They kind of like do that thing. That's what we're thinking. I'm the queen of the castle. You gotta really switch those feet up. So we were here. I'm the queen of the castle. And then you step out. Get down, you dirty rascal. Get down. That's down, up. But it's not like look at the floor. It's like somebody's in front of you and you're looking them up and down. Down, up. You look up more than you look down. Like look at their feet and look up above them. Get down. And then we step out. It's a little rib isolation. We cross. You bop by the right on that. So I'm going to face away from you guys on that. So we went, and you can't stop me because I'm the queen of the castle. Get down, you dirty rascal. Get down, around, up, and then it crosses over on that. And on that crossover, we turn around. And then you go down on this leg. I always switch it. I always get backwards. Here, this hand's behind you. And then you switch, put this one behind you. From there, you have to roll the correct way or you're gonna get tangled. You go, this right leg is out. You're gonna roll towards your right leg. Ooh, I think I'm wrong. I'm doing it backwards from you, but I'm gonna face away. Let's see here. We went, step, cross. Yeah, it is your right leg. You roll towards your right leg. So roll towards your right leg, towards the back of the room. And you end up on your stomach, facing this way. And you push back like a cat and look at the audience. And then you step up on your foot, on get down. Step up. Ooh, there's a construction truck pulling in. Step up on that foot, and you have a pirouette. It's, since you're already facing the wall, it ends up being more like 3/4 of a turn, but you push up from the floor into it, and you land front. So if I'm facing away, I went chest isolation,
step, bop, mop, around, down. I roll to the back of the room. I push up. I step, turn, land front. Let's just mark that with music.
Every day, get back there around the player, cause I'm a player.
Sit up, tomorrow, I'll hit replay, all around.
You said that.
Head trick, yeah, right, left, 1, 2, 3, 4, scoop, scoop. Pot of war, right? And around, Chaussee. Of the castle, get down, around, down, switch, and roll, push back, step up, turn, down,
get down.
Okay, so you land, that's that part where it has the little leg. Listen to this for a second. Because this is where we need to really hit some beats, hit some moments there.
So
listen.
Get down. Get down in the Tirasco. Get down. Get down. Because I'm the queen.
That's that part. We hit each sound. So you landed your pirouette. So that's that first little like click sound, click, snap up with your right, down, look, roll your shoulder. I think that's on that little breath. So it's bump, duh, 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 is what that is. And then we look front, and then you have get down. And I know everybody's learned at least that much. I think most of us will learn the next part as well. So we land in front, but. But look, shoulder, look, get down. And then we push up so that your left foot is pointed. Up. And then we push off with your right foot and walk to the back. So we landed your pirouette. Click, 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 click. Look, get down. Left, step, right. Walk to the back of your chair, and then you go here. Oh, that's on. And you have a little hand roll again when I get bored. Let's just try just that, because I really want you to look at the details on those clicks.
Get down. Get down in the Tirasco. Get down.
Up, push.
Cause I'm the queen of the castle. When I get bored, I go to court. Put up outside in my carriage, don't put my mat.
Okay. And if on any of this, if it's like I go over something and it's too fast for you, you can rewind it. Now is the best time to do that. Like while we're doing the video and not actually in class, because you can listen to the same thing that I said like 400 times if you need to. So go ahead and do that if you need to do on any of those parts. Especially on this one. Bum, ba, da, da. So over here, when I get bored, you have a chaîne turn with W arms to the right. Ooh, fine, yeah. And you jump out, and you look at the audience. So that's when I get bored, I go to court, look. And then we go, right, left, left. So it's going back. It's not like moving you super far back. You really should be moving away from the chair too, I think. Hold on, did I turn the wrong way? So sorry, guys. No, you're going towards the chair. All right, so you're going back. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then you step, little swivel hip. that this is pull up outside with a carriage. Ain't got no marriage, so I have a little flirt with the footman as he takes my fur. And we gasp, because he took your fur and he was flirting. And then we passe our left leg. And you turn to face the back. It's gonna get weird because I'm facing away from you now. So you should end up here on this side of your chair, if that makes sense. So you were have a little flirt. So you are have a little flirt with the footman as he takes my fur, and then you passe as you were and you're sitting in it. And then from there, this is the newest section that some of you might not have been here for. So go ahead. I'm just gonna kind of talk through and mark from the beginning, and then we'll go over that newer section. So go ahead and get to your chair, sit down from the beginning. Shoulder snap and down.
Sitting here all alone.
Spin around.
In the past that I happened to own, bring me some pheasant.
Keep it on the bum. Up.
Fill my goblet up.
Up to the brim.
Sipping on me, then I spit it on my
shrimp with a gold lace trim. Not very prim and proper. Can't make me stop.
I wanna go
hunting every day. Head back or up. Play up. Sit up. Till tomorrow. You walk. Window. Get down, you dirty rascal.
Get down.
Step up. Down.
Get down.
And switch. Roll.
Get down, you dirty rascal.
Step. Turn. Down. Buck, buck, duck.
Get down. Cause I'm the queen of the castle. When I get bored, I go to court.
Look at 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Step.
Have a little
flirt
with the footman.
Up, he takes my fur, passe, as you were.
Making my way to the dance floor. Some boys making a dance, I call them.
Okie doke. From there, this is the newer section. So, you have, you're facing the back. We were. Here. You have a chasse on your right foot. This is gonna get funky because we're kind of switching directions and it's gonna switch which way I'm facing you. But listen to the directions I'm saying. You're gonna go to the left using your right foot. So you're gonna chasse that way. On that. So, chasse to the left with your right foot. Then you set pas de bourrée, it goes left, right, left. So you should end up, if I was facing away from you on that pas de bourrée, it's left, right, left on pas de bourrée. So, chasse, pas de bourrée, it is a pirouette to a leap on the floor. So you have, y'all are on this foot. You're gonna pirouette and leap out of it to here on the floor. And then you're kind of facing forward and you have a little, I ignore them, because my jam. You're gonna windmill to your stomach and you have right hand looking cute. And it's same foot on that. That's looking cute. Then you roll to stand up. And you walk around yourself. It's just kind of like a sassy because it says all eyes on me. So So, walking through that again, you had your face in the back, you went passe, you sat in it, you chasse right foot, you step, pas de bourrée goes left, right, left, passe, pirouette, leap to the floor. You're on the floor in that little squat, you go, I ignore them, because my jam, you have your windmill, comes on the loot, looking cute, you have that little foot pop, then you roll to stand, das is good, all eyes on me. Let's just walk through that.
When I get bored, get out, because I'm the queen of the castle. So when I get bored,
Sinead,
I go to court.
Look, and one, two, three. One, two, three. Step, step, up.
As it takes my fur.
Passe.
As you
chasse. Pas de bourrée. Turn, leap. I draw them, cause my jam. Looking cute. Roll, walk.
No criticism.
Good, good. So, from there, I believe this is what it is. You have pull that right elbow. and then step back into it. Is, I believe, what it is. Feel free to correct me. So, no criticism. Back. Feel free to correct me if that is not what it is. I might have changed from what I wrote down originally. And then we have those little snappy snappies. Where we go, right, left. So right, left. Actually, I don't know if that posse was even there, but. From there, you have the little snappy snappies. And then we have, you face the left. And then you have that little pivot back to face the right. Pull it in, hip, hip. And then you walk up, sassy walk. And we get in that little pyramid. You put your hands on each other's shoulders. Some of you guys, I know we're not here for that formation, I think. But then Maddie in the front, she has her whole little thing. And then that's where we left off. So if you missed that end section, you didn't miss much. It's just, you've got that little pull and a snap. Snap. So pull and a snap. Up. Or is it the pull? Step, step, and we walk here on that. if you are somebody that has a video of that and you want to send it to the group message, that'd be super awesome. Because I haven't even seen that part in a while either. But let's go ahead and just walk through that, the little end section.
Get the car, go to court. Pull up outside in my carriage, don't want the marriage, so I
have a little flirt
with the footman as he takes my fur.
Passe,
as you
chasse,
making my
pas de bourrée, turn, sleep. I ignore them, it's my jam. Looking cute, roll, walk.
No criticism.
Up. And you walk. Hands, Maddie does her thing.
Okay, ladies, let's get in my formation.
Good. Okay. I'm gonna play music and kind of talk through it. You are welcome to do it this one time through with the music and me. Or if you wanna watch and do it with your video, either right or both. So here we go. From the beginning, find your spot in your chair. Roll, roll.
on the throne
in the palace that I happen to own. Bring me some pheasant up.
Fill my goblet
up to the brim.
Sipping on mead and I spill it on my
dress with a gold lace trim.
Not very
prim and copper. Can't make me stop.
I wanna go
hunting every day. Head back for up to the floor. Set up. Replay. Roll. And walk. Right. Left. 1, 2, 3, 4. Scoop. Scoop. Puddle race. Up. Bounce. Bounce. Snap. Chasse. And out. Can't stop me, cause I'm the queen of the castle. Get down. Get down. Around,
get down,
and switch, roll,
get down,
and cast, and step, turn,
get down,
and walk to your chair. When I get bored,
I go to court.
Look, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, step, 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 up. Takes my firm. Posse,
as you were.
Chasse, pas de mort. Turn, leap. I ignore them, cause my jam. Look a cute roll. Walk.
No criticism.
Up.
I look more bad than Lutheranism. Dance all that.
And up.
Okay, ladies, let's get in my formation.
So as of right now, with that dance, we've got less than a minute of it. I may decide to cut it a little shorter just because we're getting, we missed out on some of that in-class time. So it's definitely less than a minute. Right now it's like 45 seconds left. I may cut it shorter than that as well, but we will see. So what I want to work on, right now is some turns. So if you need to get on a shoe or a sock or whatever you want to use for the purpose of turning, go ahead and do that. Go ahead and put the chair away and whatever else you need to do, get a sip of water, and then get ready to turn. So, first turn I want to work on is just that pirouette to the leap, because we have it in your dance, and we had it in Christmas dance too. So you guys have been working on it for a while, but just talking about the details of it. So I can't see you to specifically give you corrections on these different things. So what you need to do is listen to all the things that I'm going to go through. And then as we're doing it, think about in your head, hey, am I remembering this part of what I need to be doing? And kind of self-check. And as always, I don't know if I told you guys this or if I told some of my other classes, but you guys can, if there's ever a step while we're away from each other that you're like, hey, I don't know if I'm doing this right, I want to get some feedback, you can just take a video or have a parent take a video of you doing it and send it to me. I'm happy to give you critiques, feedback on it. I think some of you guys, most of you guys have my phone number, so even if you wanted to text me and be like, hey, sometime can you like FaceTime me for 10 minutes and just like look at this turn, I'm happy to do it, as long as I'm not, you know, doing something else at that moment. But right now we're not dancing and we're not at work and all that good stuff, so I have plenty of time. So if you need help, let me know. We're gonna start with our right foot, and then step back right and left. We're just gonna do a ball change into it. Starts with a regular pirouette. So last week we talked about we've got to have that firm foundation, good plie. This back foot is popped up, but the front foot is flat on the floor. We're in a good solid plie. Hips and shoulders are forward. Arms are in place. My head, I have to spot, so don't look at the floor. I know sometimes we're like, oh, I can turn without spotting. You might be able to do a turn or two without spotting, but if you're trying to get them up to being able to do more turns, and particularly be able to leap out of it, you have to look up.
or you're gonna end up not being able to get as much power. So you do the pirouette first. You do one rotation round, or if you wanted to get real crazy, you could go ahead and do a double, you could do two rounds. But then once you're back to the front, the foot that's in passe, so our arms are in first, we're turning, that foot leaps out, and then we follow it to the floor. You can go ahead and take a roll out of it if you want, or you can just leap to that nice squat, either way. So I'm gonna face away from you guys. We step with the right, we step with the left, we turn, leap to the floor. If you want to roll, roll towards that hip and stand back up into that. So you have ball. Change. Up. Leap out of it to the floor, either into that squat or the roll. We're going to do it with music in a minute, and I'll kind of count it for you when to do it. If I was doing the left, I step on my left foot first, my right foot, and I pick that foot up in passe, and then I leap out of it this way to that squat. So it would go ball, change, leap to the floor, and then rolling out of there. Same things. So go ahead, check yourself, make sure that you've got your feet in the correct place, make sure you're using a good solid plie, make sure you're facing the front of the room, and you're spotting and not looking at the floor, and you're using your arms. So what we'll do is I'll count you off. We'll go 5, 6, 7, 8, turn, leap, roll, or just to that squat. Then I'll give you a second to stand back up before I count you in again. Same side, ball change up. So that'll be 5, 6, 7, 8, ball changes on 7, 8. Pirouette, leap, the floor. Let's do 4 on each side. I know we've only got the right side in your dance, but we can't be uneven, so we gotta do both.
Okay, let's see. Find the music back.
When we get back to class, we will work on fuerte turns, because I've been telling you all semester, well, all year really, that we could work on them. And then now we kind of got that a wrench thrown in things, and we're not in class anymore. But keep working on that preparation. If you keep working on that, then we will be able to work on our fuertes once we get back. So that's the deal we're gonna make on that. Make sure you're practicing. Get that strength so that you can hold your leg, and then the turn will come a little easier to us. All right, we're gonna go across the floor. Just to get us moving first, we'll just go chasse, step, leap, step, leap, step, leap. We'll do the right and then the left on that. And then we'll kind of go from there with some of our other leaps that we have. Stand up, we'll do the right and then the left, and then we'll go from there. Surprise leap. So you've got that surprise leap in your dance. So what we're going to do, the combination going across the floor, is we're going to do chasse, step, leap to the front. We're going to leap it into a squat. And you're going to roll to the right. Stand up. And then feet together. And then you're gonna go again. Chasse right, step, surprise, squat, roll, stand up. However many times that you have space for. So that surprise leap, the idea, I said this a little bit earlier, the idea is for it to look like you're about to do a leap this way, but actually you go chasse, step, and then surprise, I'm leaping to the front. So arms are up, it's just like a regular leap, but we switch where that direction is. So thinking about where your head is facing, when we do the chasse step, we're looking towards the direction that we're chassing. And then as we do that leap, boom, we flip our head to face the front. And so a leap, squat to the floor, roll, stand up, put your feet together. If you want to take a second, or if you really want to have space, do it one time, you can back up and try it a second time. But we'll go to the right, and then when we go to the left, with our left foot, we'll go chasse, step, leap front, and this time you will roll that way. Mm-hmm. Lift up, feet together, chasse, step, leap, squat. So your roll is rolling the direction that you're trying to go. So don't roll back the way you came, or you won't make it across. So we go chasse, step, leap, roll up on both sides. Okay?
If you want to do a few more things across the floor, you can look back at last week's video. I think we did more. We did some chinés and some piques and some other jumps and stuff. And I think we actually did some more turns at center as well. So we are going to be away from each other for a few more weeks. This is the last video that I'm sending out. So thinking about continuing to stretch and just doing something active, whether it's that you're dancing or maybe just going for a walk or something, but you want to keep moving, because if you sit still for the next month when you get back to dance class, you're going to be dying. So make sure you're moving, you're stretching, make sure at the very least you're practicing the dances, even if it's just watching it one time, running through it one time, whatever. I would encourage you to do the full class. Do at least one of them each week. Even if you don't, you could kind of fast forward the part where we go over the dances, and just do the stuff where we're going, doing our warm-up and our cross floor, or even if you just do a warm-up, just keeping your body moving, keeping your flexibility, thinking about dance, because this is a really long break. I know normally summer is a long break as well, but this is a long break for us to be trying to come back and finish up a dance. So keep moving. Like I said, feel free to send me questions. Parents, feel free to send me questions. I'm here if you need me. I miss you guys, and I hope you have a good rest of your month, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.